This video is based on Glowworm swarm optimization algorithm, and in this video we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, and where we can use this algorithm. Glowworm swarm optimization algorithm is introduced by Krishna Ananda and Goose in 2005. This is a nature-inspired meta-heuristic algorithm that mimics the behavior of lightning bombs in the nature. As we all know about glowworms, they are the insects and they release excess energy as glow and they emit either blue or green light and they eat other insects, and many species of glowworms also feed on fungus. So this algorithm mimics the glow behavior of glowworms. And we can use this algorithm in various fields such as in engineering, mathematics, robotics. Now we will try to understand how this algorithm is working. You know, as in nature, everything is natural and real. In this case, we have virtual glowworms, so we can call them individual agents or solution. As everything is virtual here, so we have virtual glowworms, and we know that glowworms carry luciferin along with them. Here, luciferin is the organic substance that produces light, and this is also present in the five flies. So here, each glowworm carry luciferin along with them. In real life, it is quite natural, but in this case, for luciferin, we will calculate the luciferin value for each glowworm. Now you can see here, we have certain reasons why glowworms use luciferin. They can emit luciferin to attract more glowworms toward them, or they can use this to attract mates, and they can also use this as an indicator for other glowworms from the predators. And as they eat insects, and we know insects get easily attracted toward light, so they can use this to attract insects as a food and they can eat it. Now you can see here, we have certain phases that play major role in this algorithm. Luciferin calculation, after that we will calculate the movement. Then you can see here, glowworms are selected as in the neighborhood, and after that we will update the position and then update the radius range. Now let's try to understand how we can calculate move and how we can select the neighbors and how we can update the position and range. In step one, here you can see we have step one. This is initialization phase. In this phase, we will initialize the population for the glowworms in the solution space. So here, we will randomly distribute the glowworms in the solution space. Suppose we have 5 glowworms. So randomly distribute them in the solution space. Now population is initialized. After that, as we know, glowworms carry luciferin along with them. So now here, each glowworm represent the solution of objective function. That is the fitness value that we will calculate for each glowworm using objective function plus certain quantity of luciferin. So each glowworm represent here fitness value plus certain quantity of luciferin in the, and then among all, the brighter agent is considered as the best solution. And we can update the value for the luciferin for each glowworm using this equation, and luciferin update depends on the agent's fitness value. As you can see here, this is the agent fitness value and value of luciferin at the beginning. At the beginning, we will consider the luciferin value for each glowworm same. And after that, you can see here we have two constant. And using this equation, we can calculate the luciferin, new value for each agent. Here you can see I represent the agents, and here we have 5 agents in the search space. For example, that's why value for I we have 1 to 5. So for each agent we will update the luciferin value. After that, now we have glowworms, and we also calculated the luciferin for each glowworm. Now we will update the movement for each glowworm. Here glowworm I identify other glowworms J as a neighbor, and then compute its movement. Now we will find out the neighbors for each glowworms in the space. So for each glowworm we can find out the neighbors using this equation. Here you can see this is the Euclidean distance that we will calculate between the current individual and its neighbor. So using this we can calculate the distance between two glowworms, and here using this, here you can see this is the radius of the glowworm, and you can see the luciferin value for the individual and its neighbor. So once the glowworm identify its neighbor, after that we will move the glowworms toward other glowworms having the higher luciferin level or value, you can say. Now we will move the glowworms toward the glowworms having the higher luciferin value. So for this we are using here probabilistic mechanism to select glowworms. So using this we can select the glowworms having higher luciferin level, and after that we can make the movement, and then we will update the position for each glowworm. Using this we can calculate the new position for each glowworm. You can see this is the previous position, you can see the neighbor position and the individual position. As now you can see here, using this equation we moved the glowworms and we updated their position. Now as the position for the each glowworm is updated, now we will update the range, that is the neighborhood range. Suppose for any agent, or you can say glowworm I, you can see here we have other glowworms, and you can see the range here. This is the sensor radius and this is the decision radius that we can calculate using this equation. You can see the initial neighborhood range, and then you can see the parameter that we use to control the total number of neighbors, and you can see the number of neighbors. So using this we can update the neighborhood range, so that now for the updated position it can easily find out the glowworms in the next iteration. And in the next iteration again, when the positions are updated, then again we will update the range so that it can easily find out the glowworms in the range. So you can see here we follow the main phases for glowworm swarm optimization algorithm. First we will initialize the population in the solution space. After that, for the population we will calculate the fitness values, and along with fitness values we will update the luciferin values for the each candidate, and then we will make the movement, and we will select the glowworms with higher luciferin level, and then we will update the position, and then in the end range, that is the radius range, so that in the next iteration they can easily find out the other glowworms in the solution space. So that's all about this video. In another video we will try to understand this algorithm using numerical example. So that's all about this video. If any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.